Hello, welcome to Expert Village. My name is Wayne Petersen, and I'm the director of the Important Bird Areas Program for the Massachusetts Audubon Society. Today, we're here at the Daniel Webster Wildlife Sanctuary in Marshfield, Massachusetts, where we'll be talking about bird identification and some of the equipment and essential tools that are useful to get one started in this incredibly interesting pastime. Now, in addition to the diurnal birds of prey, the hawks, eagles, and falcons, there's another whole group of birds of prey, the owls. Owls, as most people realize, are nocturnal, and most of their hunting and most of their activity actually is undertaken during the cloak of darkness. For this reason, the vocalizations or calls of owls are often as useful or as important to identifying them as is their actual appearance. But if one is fortunate enough to come across an owl roosting during the daytime in an evergreen tree or something of that sort, there are several key things that are usually important to look for. One of them is whether or not they have conspicuous tufts of feathers on the top of their head that look like ears, but of course are not their ears. Their ears are actually buried on the side of the head behind the eyes in the feathers. And also whether or not their eyes are dark or yellow. Most of our native owl species have yellow eyes, but several fairly common and widespread species also have dark eyes. The barred owl, for example, is one here in Massachusetts that has dark eyes, as is the much less common barn owl. The great horned owl, however, our largest resident species, is one that has conspicuous yellow eyes and, as the name would suggest, very prominent feather tufts on the top of the head that look like ears. The screech owl, the eastern screech owl, is another one that has feather tufts on top of its head and is peculiar in that it comes in more than one color form or morph. Some screech owls are gray, some are rusty red, and it's irrespective of whether they're males or females or adults or young. In the case of some owls like the short-eared owl, quite an unusual species here in Massachusetts, they actually will nest on the ground and are inclined to hunt over open meadows, typically at dusk and at night, very much like northern harriers, a daytime hunting hawk, only in the evening. So that in some cases we find hawks and owls occupying the same sort of niche within the habitat, but at different times of day. For example, the red-tailed hawk and the great horned owl are often found in the same environments, similar to the fact that the red-shouldered hawk and the barred owl often like wooded swamps for their nesting and otherwise activities.